Wow. Well, hello everyone. It's a quarter of an hour late. Sorry.
Oh,
We've had all
phew,
sorts of
right.
trouble. And I'll tell you who I blame. We have to blame the cat.
The cat.
The cat did
It
it.
was the cat.
Because, unbelievably, the cat, well, we've been setting up to this afternoon, doing a bit of rehearsing and stuff like that. And the cat came in. Now, the cat's a good studio cat. Normally sits, watches for a bit, looks out the window, goes off again. But today it decided to get behind the desk where all the studio equipment is, all the computers and the sound modules and everything. And it was in there for a bit and then it's come out again. Didn't think anything of it, but it's pulled all the wires out. So we couldn't connect and we couldn't understand why we couldn't connect. It's taken us all this time to figure it out. It was the cat.
The cat,
Loki the cat.
Loki,
It is named
she
after
is
the
the
Norse
god
god
of
of mischief.
mischief. She
So
really is, isn't
there
she?
you are. So it was Loki's fault.
Oh, sorry.
I know, so there you are. So anyway, we're here now. It took a bit of
Good
a while to figure it out.
grief.
We couldn't connect to the internet. We were thinking, why not? Everything's all right. But there you are. So here we
Oh,
are,
look, we've
everyone.
got
Hello,
time,
everyone.
but
Everyone's raring to go, aren't
blimey,
they?
yeah, we've
Look,
got
blimey. Up.
30 in already.
I should start playing and singing then.
Wow.
Izzy's here, of course. Have a
Hi,
chat with
dear.
Izzy.
Hello.
There she is. And we'll get cracking and try. We'll do everything a bit fast and try and make up the time, shall we? There we go then. Ribbon of Highway. Everyone's saying, oh, sorry, we're late. We couldn't find you. No, we weren't on.
No, we weren't.
So you're all right. Yeah, don't panic. There's nothing wrong with your system. It was us this time. Yeah, well, it was the cat. I tell you what, if Yester's downstairs and listening, she wants to bring the culprit cat up so it can be admonished, then we will, if she can get hold of it. By the scruff of the neck, bring it in and say, look what you did. Look what you did.
Name and shame.
Name and shame the cat. We will name and shame Loki the cat. You can see her. If Yester can catch her and bring her in, then she won't go where she doesn't want to go. So.
No. Apparently we've got a cactus down as well.
I don't know what's happening with this cactus. Look.
It really doesn't want to work.
It doesn't want to work, this one. Look, it's trying to.
Have you put new batteries in?
I have put new batteries in it.
Wow.
Unless they've gone already. Look. Oh, let's try two new ones. Look, let's fully charge it.
All right.
Let's get rid of these ones. That was working at the start because I made sure it was working. So let's see if this helps. We're going to put brand new batteries. No expense spared, ladies and gentlemen, for this show. Oh, there you go. Look, it was a battery related. That's where it's what you get for using half dead batteries in these things. Oh, man, that's bright, isn't it? Look at that.
Now it puts the other one to shame.
The other one looks a bit pathetic, doesn't it? Let's put this one over here. Wow, I'm blind. There. God, look at how bright that is now. Look, under my armpit. Look, God. It's shining under my armpit. There you are.
Oh, dear.
Right. Right, well, we better crack on, haven't we? Mr. Lonely.
Debutantes and socialites and mamas from the PTA. We got bachelorettes dressed up in white, a little black as people say. Long live the blues, they're keeping me in business. Some wanna dance, some wanna party, whatever they need, they call me. It's a lonely, it's a good time. Mr. Lonely gonna want on a Saturday night when you're lonely, lying in the dark. I'm the number that you know by a broken heart. No, I ain't Mr. Right, I'm Mr. Right Now. The one all the girls are talking about, the one and only Mr. Lonely. Yeah, some are in from out of town, just looking for some fun. You can find me in a poker on a bathroom wall. When you all wanna run them busy, they call me the lonely, Mr. Good Time. Mr. One you're gonna want on a Saturday night when you're lonely, lying in the dark. I'm the number that you know by a broken heart. No, I ain't Mr. Right, I'm Mr. Right Now. The one all the girls are talking about, you're lonely, Mr. Lonely. Never start a fight, cause when she hangs up on you, guess it's on the other line. It's never hard to find Mr. Lonely, Mr. Good Time. Mr. One you're gonna want on a Saturday night when you're lonely, light in the dark. I'm the number that you know by broken heart. No, I ain't Mr. Right, I'm Mr. Right Now. The one all the girls are talking about, the one lonely, Mr. Lonely. One and only, Mr. Lonely. Long live the blues.
Ah, yeah. Well, that's a lively old start. Although we are a bit late, but never mind. We'll try and catch up for lost time.
Yes.
So we've got a couple of three requests as well as... as the usual stuff. And now what I'm trying to do now, I'm going to run up to the clubs opening on the 17th. I think some clubs are opening on the 17th of this month, I think. And certainly the classes are, aren't they? Classes are sometimes. Some people are doing outside classes already, which is great. So what I'm trying to do is trying to get as many floor fillers on as we can so you can oh, yes, I'm up for this now. And when you get out there, you're out straight out there. So, well then. So this is us. This is us a quarter of an hour ago. It's called Missing, this one.
Yeah, we certainly were.
I say. Oh, Sue says we're sounding good. Are you still in the Cotswolds, Sue?
They are, yes. In the Cotswolds. She was worried about a signal, but she's got a bit of a signal, so.
I know. See, I mean, they've only just got broadband over there, haven't they, apparently. Quite soon, Sue, they're going to get you go to the pictures, it's going to be in colour with sound, I'm told. Here we are then.
A little beach town, but you won't find me, 'cause I can't be found. I'm on a mission to be missing. I'll be back someday, I just don't know when. Until then, I'll be a feather floating in the wind. So don't you go missing me, 'cause sometimes missing is my favorite place to be.
Missing, there we are. Cool, I tell you what, it's getting warmer, isn't it? Because I'm feeling the heat already, feeling the heat. The heat is on, the heat is on. I could do that song, couldn't I? That's not Footloose, that's a different song, isn't it?
No, completely different
song. That's a different song.
Yeah. Is it Glenn Frey?
It might be.
Glenn
Fry from the Eagles.
Yes.
From Eagles.
From Eagles.
Not the from Eagles. Oh, did anybody spot that? I lost my lead halfway through. I tried my lead.
I tried to be discreet. See, look,
I can't see that. Look, you can't really see that in there. There it is. Look, there it is. There's my lead. The thing that makes the guitar work, right? And if you're a proper professional, if you're in the back in the clubs, if you're a proper professional, what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to wrap it around your strap. Always wrap it around your strap.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, you always rely on the strap, everybody. So if you've got the strap like that, then when you tread on it, it doesn't pull out. But me, being a complete amateur,
I didn't do that.
Yeah. So when I trod on my lead, it came out. But Izzy was there. She was like a proper rock and roll roadie there.
Yes.
On the crouch, she came running onto the stage.
Like lightning.
Grease lightning. So, Texas time, everybody. Texas time.
Alan noticed that.
Yeah, I know.
He's on the ball.
Well, it's good to know that people notice a difference in sound when the guitar was unplugged.
Yes.
Unlike that picture of Kenny Chesney where he's actually playing a guitar with nothing plugged into it at all. And there's a little arrow just pointing to the hole in the guitar where there's supposed to be a lead. This is in front of about 10,000 people, mind you. Texas time. So it's time for a bit of Keith. Oh, a bit off. I did it. Wow, I haven't done that in ages. I haven't done that in ages.
Yes.
You think after a year and a half, I'd get used to not saying a bit of. Bit of an I know. I was saying all the time, wasn't I?
I know.
There we are then. Texas time. If you can remember it, have a go.
City, oh.
Texas time. Andy's in. Andy, Arizona.
Arizona's in, yeah.
He's been on his boat.
Is he on the roof tonight?
Is he on the... No, I, you know what? I saw him on his boat. I saw him on his boat. I because he went off in my pocket.
Hello.
I was talking to Izzy in the room a bit earlier on, and she said, "What's that noise?" And it was my phone, wasn't it, in my pocket. It started on its own. And so I looked on it to see what it was, and it was Andy Arizona's feet in some kind of canoe. And he was paddling along.
Yeah.
Well, I assume it was. It might have been the prow, the bow of his huge yacht that he might have.
Yes.
But it was just the pointy bit, basically. I assumed, I might be wrong, I assumed he was in a little tiny dinghy paddling away on a canoe or something. Or a kayak. Or possibly a pedalo. It wasn't a pedalo, though, because I couldn't see his feet moving. But, so it prompts us.
It might have been one of them swans at Lakeside or something.
It could have been one of them. I've been on a pedalo. But this is so while Andy's here, then we'll do Andy's dance, which is Need a Boat. Need a Boat. And this is oh dear, hang on. Hey, what? It's all going wrong here. Technically, we're not doing very well today, are we? Not at all. So Need a Boat. Now, this is it's kayak. See, I know me ships. It's not really a ship, is it?
Ships.
I know. The
kayak.
SS Andy.
Yeah.
No, SS Arizona. Yes. I bet he's got a name and everything. Oh, Sue's got a bad connection now. Well, you are in the Cotswolds.
Oh,
where they've only just invented sheep.
Just invented sheep.
Yeah. So this is Andy's dance to this song. He's got one. It's called Need a Boat. His dance is called Need a Boat as well. So and I'm going to have a crack at it now. So here we are, Morgan Wallen song, Need a Boat.
This whiskey sure tastes fine right now, but it ain't doing the trick, nah. It ain't getting me calmed up to make my mind forget. That one shot, two shot, three shot, four. Don't change the fact she ain't in the picture anymore. This bar stool ain't working, but if anything can, it'll be me on a dock, pushing off a dry land. I eat a lake, a little bit of bait. I'd even take a creek. I'm tired of all these concrete streets we're running down. Yeah, what I need right now is a lot less meaning. First catch a feeling, praying to the man for some muddy water. Sad song on my radio, turning up some black smoke down a back road. I need a boat. I need a boat. Don't care if it's a pontoon being used, long as that little fish. Just cast it out yonder, let my mind wander off to anything but this. And I'm tired of running all my friends, asking if I'm over her loving. Get it out there with a riddle, let's send them fish, don't ask me nothing. I need a lake, a little bit of bait, I'd even take a creek. I'm tired of all these concrete streets we're running down. Yeah, what I need right now is some rotten and some feeling. First catch feeling, bring it to the man for some muddy water healing. Don't need no sad song on my radio, burning up some black smoke down. I'm tired of all these concrete streets we're running down. Yeah, what I mean right now is some rotten and some feeling. First catch feeling, bring it to the man for some bloody water healing. Don't need no sad song on my radio, burning up some black smoke down a back road. I need a boat.
Jaws, that was just Jaws, like Jaws.
Yes, he's going to need a bigger boat. I mean, the fish, and that's definitely Jaws, isn't it?
Yeah.
Wow.
This, you know, you maintain that that's one of the greatest films ever made.
It is.
Jaws.
I love it.
Now, she laughs at me when I say Galaxy Questies.
I was watching another great today, wasn't I? Close Encounters.
Close Encounters of the Third Kind.
Yes. Yeah.
You'd moan at me, though. If I did that with my spuds, you'd have a right go. If I turned them into a... my mashed potato mountain.
We used to do that.
Oh, Fiesa's there. Oh, she's... Oh, there we go. Look, she spent £100. I know.
Over £100.
Oh, that's great, isn't it? That's great. That all goes into the coffers.
Yeah, daughters are the best.
They are. Oh, yeah. There we are. If anybody's interested in Izzy's Avon, then just go and have a look on your page because you do.
Join my group, Ding Dong.
Ding Dong, Izzy's Avon.
Yes.
Mrs.
He's supposed to join my group. He's Ding Dong, Izzy's Avon.
Mrs. Yes. Ding Dong.
Ding Dong.
They don't do that anymore, though, do they? Because you can do it online.
Yeah, that's it.
Doesn't matter where you are in the country. She's not going to come with a little box of Avon to your house unless you live in round about our street. She's not going to do that. Yeah, but it can go. It gets delivered, doesn't it? It's all very modern now. Anyway, whiskey under the bridge. Oh, it reminds me. I haven't actually had a little tipple yet.
You haven't?
No. There is no whiskey in that.
There isn't.
So if you actually have a drink of neat whiskey, but you don't put it in your Coke, because this is 12-year-old single malt, bunk, that I'm drinking out of a bottle. So.
That's so uncouth.
It's not sacrilege though, because I'm not mixing it.
Okay. Did that just squeak?
It's a proper, it's look. Sweet. It's a proper pork. It's not a twisty one. It's like...
Oh, dear.
I don't know. Oh, it's been a long 58 weeks, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
All right, whiskey under the bridge. Are we ready? Here we go. It ain't been broken, a lot of it ain't been spoken. A shattered dream that brand new love can't fix. I've been hurt, I've been cheated, but this old heart's still beating. Ain't no big deal, it's just a whiskey under the bridge. Let's dance a little closer. I'll help you get over the hurt you thought you never could forget. The bitter tears that you tasted and all those nights you wasted. Don't look back, it's just whiskey out of the bridge. Well, all those nights you're drinking, finally got
It's just a whiskey on an average. Whoa, ain't no big deal. It's just a whiskey on an average. Whoa, ain't no big deal. It's just a whiskey on an average. Whiskey under the bridge. Ah, oh. See, Steph loves that one because she's Brooks and Dunn mad. She loves Brooks and Dunn. So who doesn't? To be honest, who doesn't?
Yeah.
Well, we've had the whiskey. Now it's tequila time. Mm. And this is a song all about tequila. Codigo, which is a brand of tequila, and it's made by George Strait. It's his own brand. He bought a tequila factory, and it's his own brand. So what he's done is he's written a song about it, which is fantastic marketing, really. When I finally get a factory that manufactures some kind of drink, then I'm going to do a similar thing. I don't know what my drink would be, mind you. What do you think I should have? What should I invest in? Metal polish strained through a football sock. So, I'm sorry, James, I don't know that one. Cover Me Up by Morgan Wallen. He's funny, Morgan Wallen. Some of his songs I really, really, really like, and some of his songs I think are awful. He's quite Marmite because he does this thing where he's kind of quite 80s country stuff, and then he goes like proper 2020, and it's all like hip-hop beats and auto-tune and all that, and I hate it. So it might be one of those, which I don't know, but I'm not familiar with the song, James. I will look it up. But in the meantime, this is proper old sounding. It's not an old song, mind you. Codigo, George Strait. Here we go.
Baby, just like you, it's something new. I just had to try. I didn't plan on it, but the sip and you want it, it's a beautiful high. Perfect recipe, baby, you and me. The secret's been found, let's pour one right now. I'm talking about Codigo, I take it with me everywhere I go. Best tequila, baby, don't you know. A little sip and you're ready to roll. They make it down in Mexico, a little say called Jalisco, where the beautiful agaves grow. Oh, I'm talking about Codigo. Any way you like it, any way you want to try it, I'll try it too. I don't care if it's a habit, as long as I have it and I have it with you. Hasta la Cruz, I'll be singing to you. All the way home, we'll make this our song. I'm talking about Codigo, I take it with me everywhere I go. Best tequila, baby, don't you know. A little sip and you're ready to roll. They make them down in Mexico, a little saint called Jalisco, where the beautiful agaves grow. I'm talking about Codigo. Straight up or on the rocks, dressed up all night, naked surprise. Throw it back and close your eyes. I'm talking about Codigo, take it with me everywhere I go. Best tequila, baby, don't you know. A little sip and you're ready to roll. They make it down in Mexico, a little state called Jalisco, where the beautiful agaves grow. I'm talking about Codigo. I'm talking about Codigo, I take it with me everywhere I go. Best tequila, baby, don't you know. A little sip
Cody Go. Oh, a song all about tequila. Well, yes. That's Sue and David have had to go.
Oh.
Apparently, obviously, the Cotswolds has run out of broadband.
They've used up
all their 4G allowance.
So. Oh, bless them. We'll see them soon.
We'll see them soon. We're back on Thursday. They always pop in on a Thursday, don't they? So. Yeah. And not long before we're at their one of their regular clubs, which is Manston in June.
Manston in June. Yes.
Yeah, and I did see Bob Keeley was in a bit earlier on. I don't know if he's still there or not. He might have just popped in. Yeah, he wanted to know if I was wearing his jacket.
Oh.
Oh, you wish, Bob. You wish you had this jacket. He loves this jacket. Ah, well. Aww. So... While I've got this one on, then, it's and Arlette is here, so it is time now to have our usual slap in the face to the French, which is Bonaparte's Retreat.
Yes.
I don't know. Their greatest national hero, I think. Oh, that or Charles Aznavour, maybe.
Maybe the peace I got for good. Sacha Distel.
Sacha Distel, yeah.
He's French, isn't he? One
drops keep falling on my head.
Yeah.
Oh, thank heaven for little girls.
No, I don't think you can sing that.
You can't sing that anymore,
no,
can
no,
you?
No.
That's the one you don't hear on the radio very often now, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anyway, Maurice Chevalier, of course. Maurice. Anyway, this is... Bonaparte's Retreat, of course, if you're good with the dance. Are you ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Met the girl I love in a town way down in Dixie, meet the stars up above. She was the sweetest girl I ever did see, so I held her in my arms and of many charms. I kissed her while the kids all played. Bonaparte's Retreat, yeah.
Done.
That was very well done.
Ooh, thank you.
Ah.
Oh, no,
Oh, yeah. Serious, please. She hasn't seen a bagpipes for a long time.
No, she hasn't seen. I'm not even going there.
Oh, God.
Oh, well. I'll tell you what else we haven't seen. Neither of the girls has been able to capture the cat and bring her in.
No.
I thought that might have happened by now.
She's obviously on a,
over that, on a mission. It's got claws.
Yes.
They might have been mortally wounded trying to do that.
But she doesn't want to be caught.
We've got a wormer later as well. Oh, God, we could do that live on screen, couldn't we?
Do a live worming of
live
the cat.
Worming of the cat. Anything for tips, really.
Well, yeah.
Well.
Okay.
Well, rock this town. We haven't done this in ages either. And so talking of cats, because we've got a fantastic, well, it's not really ours, is it? It's just a cat that we really like. Whenever
he lives in a car park, doesn't he?
Whereabouts is the
Borough Green?
Borough Green. Oh, it's not far from us. It's a car park in Borough Green, which is where Izzy goes sometimes. And when she parks her car, there's a cat that comes in, and he's your friend. He's like, and he seems to be stray.
Yes.
So we've called him Brian Setzer. Because he's a stray cat. Right.
Yay. Okay, right. So, I think they should see him.
People, everybody's been asking to see Brian for ages and ages. So we've got pictures now. We've got live pictures of Brian.
Here he is. Hang on. Here we go. There he is.
There's Brian.
He's actually sat on top of my car.
That's on top of my car. That's your Mini, isn't it?
That's my Mini.
There you go. And there he is there. And he's trying to think about getting in the window.
Yeah, look. I just took so many pictures. He was brilliant.
There he is, Brian. Brian the cat. Yeah, he's always he's asleep. Now. Settled down now. It's quite nicely.
That's why I'll wait for my mum to get her hair done in the hairdresser.
Now he's on the wind. He's right in front of the windscreen now, so make sure he can't drive off.
And he's so friendly.
And there he is inside.
He's got in my car.
I know.
I thought I was going to be arrested.
For catnapping,
I know.
There
but
we are.
Just got in.
That's Brian. Yeah, and there he is, having a little rollabout.
Yeah.
Before you ran him over accidentally.
I didn't.
No, there he is. That's Brian. That's Brian Setzer of the cat.
That's Brian. Yeah. Anyway, which brings you on.
It's neatly on to.
To the next song.
Rock This Town, which of course is Brian Setzer and Stray Cats. And Rock This Town is the dance, of course. Let's go, cats! this town. Oh, wow, there you are.
Yeah.
Ah, Brian, the stray cat.
Yes. Brilliant.
Everybody loves him. I can hear no screams from downstairs. I assume they're not trying to catch the cat anyway.
I don't think
they probably can't find her.
No. Oh, Michelle is bobbing in the kitchen.
Oh, well.
Cool.
Excellent. That's what we like to hear. Well, we've got why not? Another one. It is all the kind of popular dances that I haven't done in a bit. One More Last Chance. It's a song. It's Final Chance is your dance. That's a Vicky Morris.
Mm-hmm.
Vicky Morris wrote this one to a Vince Gill tune. And one of my favourites, actually. One of my favourites of all time. So this is One More Last Chance. Final Chance is the line dance, of course. So here we go. Like so. Front door. Doing too bad. I thought everybody would go to watch a deck at 7 o'clock, but they're still here.
No.
There you are.
Still here, yeah.
Now Polly's still here. I know she's still here. She watches from start
Polly
to finish.
Polly would never miss her.
She reckons that she's watched everyone.
I think she has.
She might have watched everyone.
Absolutely.
Pretty much all of everyone. Anyway,
yeah.
I mean, occasionally people have to pop out, don't they, or go and make a cup of tea or have a whiddle.
Oh, yeah.
But so she don't have a few bits she might have missed, but. That's 60, that's 68, oh, 58, sorry, 58, that's 116,
well, yeah.
116,
and that's 58.
Yeah, but 50. Yeah. So it's a 58 of each. That's 116.
Yes,
times that by two, because that's the number of hours, right? Yeah. That's 300 hours. That's almost like the whole of Game of Thrones.
I bet we're as good
without
as
the boobies. No boobies or dragons, but that could be arranged.
Well, no? Well, you say that.
I can't even get a cat in here, let alone a.
No, I know.
Yeah, alone a dragon. So anyway, this is for Polly. Imagine that.
Look, Wendy's watched them all
too.
I know.
Yeah,
they're
awesome.
We do know.
We do know who's watching. Yeah. It's amazing. I'm amazed.
I know. Bless you all.
And, what can we say? I mean, we are just so grateful to everybody that watches. I'm sure we can do it. James is new, isn't he? Is this the first one James has seen, possibly?
Well,
we know James from old.
James, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm sure James. We can find a Garth Brooks one to stick in for you, James. So, because he's asked twice nicely now.
He has, yeah.
Sonia, Game of Thrones is possibly the best thing that television has ever come up with. It's fantastic. It is an incredible investment in your time, though. And you do get to see Jason Momoa with no clothes on.
Oh.
Quite often. Not that I'm just saying that for the ladies. That doesn't really do anything for me, personally, but... Anyway, this is for Polly. It's Imagine That. And this is a lovely Don Williams and Keith Urban collaboration, believe it or not. And it goes like so. Well, I've got no noise coming out of this.
Uh-oh.
I think it's working. Here we go.
The wall, someone to laugh with.
But all I can do is imagine that.
There we are, imagine that. Imagine that's for Polly. So, here we are. Let's take that off. Oh, I've got it tangled up again.
Yeah, oh, hello.
There, like that. That's it. Ah, well. Oh, everybody's going Garth Brooks mad for some reason today. It wasn't the Garth Brooks song I had in mind, really, but shall I do that one instead? I'll do that one instead, shall I?
Yes.
As everyone seems to be asking.
We're still talking about Game of Thrones. Can you get it on Netflix?
Yes, you can.
You can.
And I think they're even showing it on something else at the moment, aren't they? I think they're showing it on, possibly on
Amazon Prime.
Is it on Amazon Prime? I think it's on pretty much all of them, isn't it, now? Yeah. I think we watched it on... I think we watched it on Netflix, didn't we?
Netflix, I think, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We used to sit up till 4 or 5 o'clock.
Yeah, yeah, trying to catch up. Because the girls were in front of us to start with, weren't they? Yes. And then we had to kind of, like, catch up with them. And it was only because everyone was going on about it. So I'm going to do the same with Line of Duty now. We're going to start from the start. So don't tell us anything.
No.
Because everyone seems to be raving about that. And the other one that we're watching at the moment is Loofah. Loofah.
Yes.
I believe it's supposed to be spelt. Loofah.
Loofah.
And we've just started the second series of that now, haven't we?
Yes.
So, but Game of Thrones is absolutely... It's got everything, hasn't it? It's got action. It's got nudie bits. It's got politics and intrigue. There's fighting and war and explosions. It's just got everything. It's great.
Yes.
So, now, this is a special, really, because we don't normally do this on a Saturday, because this is like... Ooh, something about a live stream. Looks more like a scam. Is that me?
Ooh,
am I a scam?
Are you a...
Am I a scam?
No, Rachel knows you.
Oh, yeah, no. I'm not a scam.
Oh, who's that, Rachel?
I mean, if I am a scam, or is it somebody who's actually on the thing? Is it a thingy that we've missed?
I don't know.
Is somebody trying to sell us stuff in Nigeria?
Yes.
I mean, if I am a scam, please let me know what your bank account details are so I can deposit...
Yes.
£9,000,000,000 into your bank account, and you will get 10% of that. Trust me on that one. So this is I don't normally do this on a Saturday, as I was saying, because normally this is a line dance spec, but is it kind of... There's not a line dance, a couple's dance to this, isn't there? Is there a line dance to this one?
What? I don't know what you're gonna do. Oh, that one. It's actually called Sleazy Slide.
Sleazy Slide. There we are. Thank you.
Sleazy Slide.
My trusty assistant.
Yes.
So this is for James and anybody else that wanted it. That's completely the wrong song. I don't know where that came up. That's the one I want.
Blame it all on my roots. I showed up in boots and ruined your black tie affair. The last one to know, the last one to show, I was the last one you thought you'd see there. And I saw the surprise and the fear in his eyes as I took his glass of champagne. Oh, how close did you say, honey, we made me throw. You'll never hear me complain. Cause I got friends in low places where the whiskey drowns and the beer chases my blues away. And I'll be okay. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not big on social rises. Think I'll step on. Everything's alright. I just say the night and I
I deviated from the programme there to do that one.
Yeah. We had a guest slip in there.
Garth just popped in there, didn't he? Just for a minute or two.
Oh, I broke me.
Oh, you've broken your microphone.
Look.
Uh-oh, look at that.
Oh, look, he's splintered. I've got splinters in it.
I bet Garth doesn't get splinters off his microphone. Yeah. Oh, time for a bit of Midland now. Midland. Miss Brummage. Walsall. I actually come from Texas. There's a Midland in Texas.
Yeah.
That is actually... I didn't actually realise. Did you know we watched another binge watch series we watched was Heroes? You've not seen that? That's great.
Yes.
That's really good. That took us ages to get through as well, didn't it?
It goes on and on.
And it's really good. Yes. It's all about people who accidentally discover they have superpowers and don't know what to do with them.
Mm-hmm.
And it's called Heroes. And a lot of it is set in Midland in Texas. Because that's where the cafeteria is. It's supposed to be set in Midland.
Right.
It seems quite a sleepy little place. Apart from the fact there's superheroes running around all over the place there. It made me think, you know, Chernobyl was what, 40 years ago this year, wasn't it? 40 years ago, Chernobyl. Still no superheroes. Nothing. Not one person who was bit by a radioactive spider, nothing. Makes you wonder if it's not true, all that stuff.
No. Watch Chernobyl as well.
Chernobyl, what a series that is.
God.
That is shocking and unbelievable.
That
is great. Anyway, Midland Playboys, this is called Playboys.
She said, I guess there ain't no right way to say goodbye again. You've been looking at the highway where your heart has always been. I could cuss you from here to Tucson. There ain't nothing left to say, boys. She said, I thought that I could change you. Ah, but you were born a playboy. Let's get on the stage and play, boys. Let's kick out the lights tonight and get high and make noise. We might drink a little too much whiskey. We might have a little too much fun. It's already gone away, boys. If we don't go home, what difference does it make, boys? The world would be a dull place, boys, if it was all work and no play, boys. 100 miles outside of Houston, third name on the marquee sign. That ain't you get used to losing your friends, your lovers, and your mind. Get on the stage and play, boys. Let's kick out the lights tonight and get high and make noise. Yeah, let's drink a little too much whiskey. Yeah, let's have a little too much fun. Since I'm already gone away, boys. If we don't go home, what difference does it make, boys? This old world could be a dumb place, boys. It was all work and no play. Don't know no other way.
Playboys. Ah. Talking about Nashville now.
Nashville.
Yes. Nashville, Nashville was great. We loved Nashville.
Get the teeth in.
Yes. Yes, we loved Nashville, didn't we?
Yes.
I actually think that who was the girl that was also in
Heroes.
In Heroes. What's her name? She's Claire in Heroes, Claire, but she's what is she in Nashville? Someone's going to tell me in a minute. It's
Fiesta, who is it?
Anyway, the blonde one. The blonde one. The blonde bratty one. One. Yes. The blonde bratty one. Yes. Completely reminds me of Nadine.
Mm-hmm.
Completely. And what's her name now? I can't remember.
Her name is...
No,
it's gone.
No, it's gone. But she was kind of like the sort of like Carrie Underwood, sort of like Leanne Rimes sort of person, wasn't she? Yeah, I loved it. Loved it. And the music was good. In actual fact, in the later series, they cut down on the music, which is a bit of a shame. Because in the first few, that you got like virtually a whole song, didn't you? And then after a while, they had like little tiny bits of song. Because apparently they couldn't afford the royalties to Hayden. That's Hayden. We're thinking of the character. Juliet Barnes.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, but apparently they had to keep changing production companies. That's why it went from sort of like company to company. And then they cancelled it at one point, and there was a big outcry. And so they brought it back again, and it ended up on sort of like Channel 5 or something, didn't it, here? But they couldn't afford the royalties for the songs. So they had chopped down the songs to keep the price down. How about that? Anyway, how long have we got now? Well, we got half an hour. That's great. I've got loads of time. Loads of time.
Yeah, yeah.
What haven't I not done here? Well, we're doing quite well here. We're doing quite well. Day of the Dead.
Hello.
Yes, Day of the Dead. So I'm going to put another guitar on there. We're going right through the guitars today.
Yes.
They're all getting a go. So this is, of course, all about
these. We've done this for ages, haven't we?
When is the Day of the Dead? It's in, is it coming up soon? Or is it near Halloween?
September.
Just before Halloween, or is it a month
Jasmine
before?
Jasmine
will know exactly the date. Yes. I'm thinking of Cinco de Mayo, which is different, isn't it? Which is the 5th of May. I'm not even getting going on that May the 4th. Oh, rubbish.
May the
4th be with you.
No.
Not in this house, I say. I'm a Star Trek, I'm a Galaxy Quest man myself.
Oh, look, Cliff and Anna Marine.
Oh, Cliff and Anna.
Yay.
Cliff and Anna. They've come in from their bike ride, probably.
Yes.
Right, this is Day of the Dead, of course, if you are dancing.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. It's 110 here in Lajitas. Piñatas on the promenade. Sunday best painted faces. Lining up for the parade. Oh, the river's down here in Lajitas. Staring down the banks of Mexico. Wondering if they'd ever notice if I slipped across and just kept drifting on. It's the Day of the Dead here in Lajitas. And that's the impression under the stone. Now I love gone home to Jesus. You're wearing white, San Antonio.
said he once wore my shoes. I finally left him in some alley in Juarez, and he had nothing left to lose. You and I were dancing toe to toe, barefoot on the Paso Tio. I woke up clinging to a ghost.
Trumpet in.
That was, I had a good trumpet there.
Good top trump that was.
Gets
up your head. Oh, so, wow. Hang on, let's get this. So Cinco de Mayo, obviously I'm fluent in Spanish, but that indicates to me 5th of May, Cinco de Mayo, right? Cinco being 5, yet it's on the 30th of April.
Yeah.
How does that work? How comes Cinco de Mayo is in April?
I don't know.
Unless I'm mistaking Cinco de Mayo for actually what it actually means is the 30th of April in Spanish. Yeah. Possibly. I don't know. Well, there you are. Well.
Okay.
Ooh. Well then. Let's get the old rock and roll guitar out again. And so we're going to do 7 Nights to Rock. And then last week, was it last week or the week before? Last week, God, I can't remember. I'm getting so old. We had we had everyone singing this one,
yes,
didn't we? But obviously the girls are hiding downstairs. Yeah, they won't even come and bring the cats to show everybody.
No. So they can't get hold of a cat.
No, that's because they're probably in their PJs.
They haven't got their face on.
I don't know. That'd be quite funny, actually. They haven't got their faces on. They've probably got their. They've probably got their. You know, when they come. They go with like white face with cucumbers on their eyes, don't they? They could come up like that. That'd be funny. Green face, really.
Face pack. Yeah.
Come up in green face. But like aliens. holding a cat. So anyway, Seven Nights to Rock is your song, and your dance, of course, is all week long, because you've got to shout out the days of the week.
Yeah.
Let's give it a go. I should hope so, in shame. Oh, this is Jasmine, of course.
Hello. Without the beard.
Why didn't I come on during Day of the Dead?
She's got a Day of the Dead shirt, look.
The Day of the Dead cat.
See, we're not lying. She really is into the Day of the Dead stuff.
Yes. And it was, what did you say? The celebrating the...
The Day of the All Saints and the Day of the All Souls. So it's 1st and the 2nd of November. Cinco de Mayo is about a Mexican war over the French. It's completely different.
All right. On the 30th of April.
On the 5th of April.
5th of May.
But it lasts like a whole week.
Oh, okay. Oh,
awesome. So everyone celebrates it.
It's a bit like us with the Battle of Britain.
Yeah, kind of. So proud.
Well done. She's that was great. Yes. Are you going to stay for 12 bar Saturday night? You're going to go away? Because you need to hear it, don't you?
I'll stay for 12 bar Saturday.
Would you like some earphones or something so you can hear it? That can be arranged.
Where are they?
Where's the tech expert?
Oh, God, no.
Oh, excellent.
There we go. Let's grab them. I've just got to plug them in. Hang on.
This is not rehearsed, ladies and gentlemen.
No, this is...
Can you tell?
Hang on. Let's plug you into something. What should we plug you into? Oh, let's put you into that one. I believe that's going to work. Can you hear anything?
Yes. Loud and clear. I didn't get electrocuted.
Right, let's try this then. So this is the song that I wrote in my own brain. 12 bar Saturday dance is your dance,
yes,
isn't it?
Yes.
I can't do the dance.
You can't do the dance?
No.
Oh, I don't know how the dance goes. Everyone says it's a good
dance.
I was never good at line dancing when I was little. So
All right.
I'll make it up.
What a voice, though. Here we go.
Oh. the 12 bar Saturday night.
Hey, there you are. Well done.
Yay.
What a pro. She just comes in.
That's
no
it.
Rehearsal.
We've taught her well.
Yes. There we are.
Not the 6-7 years of acting classes, no.
Well, if you want to do the doo-doos, we're doing Soul Shake next.
I can stay for the doo-doos.
You can stay for the doo-doos. Because we're doing all the sing-along stuff now. It's like the community singing at Wembley Cup final. Everybody remember that? I'm so old.
No, you're so old.
Let's try it on this guitar for a change. I don't normally do it on this guitar, but I think it might sound quite good. So Soul Shake. So, are you ready to do doos?
Yes.
And you've got your. Would you like a hairbrush or something as well? You've got nothing to hold to do on.
No.
There's nothing here. Oh, we've got something. What's this?
Hang on.
Hello.
Seriously?
You can. You could do that.
There's going to be some interesting screenshots of this one.
Okay.
Yeah, that's like a, just assume that's it's a microphone.
Yeah.
We'll pretend.
I feel weird holding this.
Here we go then. do. Ooh, well done. Well,
it was very good. It came alive at one point.
It did.
Yes, it had a life of its own.
Yes.
Cat Muppet thing.
Another cat toy.
I know. Oh. And then there's, we can turn the lights off now if you want to see at any point.
Oh, God, yes.
There's just Fiesta downstairs complaining about the doo-doos.
Don't mind my migraines.
Complaining about my doo-doos.
Yeah, no, I don't think this, she means the doo-doos.
This from the family vegetarian. it's lovely. Here we are. This is nice. It's our party now, isn't it? It's a party.
It is,
would you like
yes.
a drink? I've got some just ordinary Coke there if you want some.
No, I'm okay.
You're right. Jasmine doesn't drink.
She doesn't. She's a good girl.
She doesn't drink. She doesn't smoke.
She's sin her mum.
Don't drink. Don't smoke. No, what do you do? You don't drink. Don't smoke. What do you do?
Anyway.
I actually get that reference.
I know. Here you are. Look. See? And she's only a bibby.
Oh, a bibby.
A bibby.
If you say so.
Oh, I love some like you, Nicole, you're a ripper, Sheila. It's Keith Urban time, everybody.
We could
do the extended, carry on for another 5 minutes, like the one on the record. Oh, well, what have we got time for now? We've got time for two more, I reckons. So what should we do first? Oh, let's do this one first. One too many. Half past tipsy. Half past tipsy.
Fiesta will be flinging herself about.
She'll
downstairs.
Be flinging herself about downstairs. I'm surprised she hasn't come up.
I know.
There's got to be something going on down there. Like she's literally like...
immersed in a colouring book.
She's colouring downstairs. Colouring? Whilst listening to us, I hope.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. On the big colouring screen.
But she won't come up and enjoying in the fun.
Not tonight.
She's a bit shy.
I'm the obvious replacement.
This is it, yeah.
We're about 4 foot difference.
That's right, yeah. Because if Fiesta stands here, you see, you can't see her because this is right in her face. It's like you literally peep over the top. But Fiesta's face is about there. So Uh-oh. So she always has to stand over this side. So we have to clear out the studio. So she's got somewhere to stand.
Yes.
Anyway, one too many, everybody. Half past tipsy. Coming nearly to the end now, we've got one after this, and then I think it's KD at 8, isn't it? Well, I caught a cough, rattled around 6 o'clock, sing a call, a hankering for a honky tonk. What's a nice gold beer and a country song, but he didn't want to stay out all night long. Well, I ain't the kind of little buddy to go home, but I can't. Turn it off, once I turn it on, there's no stopping me once I get going. Put a pin in my hand and I'm wide as open. The tick-tock of that clock is my time bomb. I head fast till I'm half-bells, gypsy, quarter to 12, and I'm gone head ready. The countdown's on when the first beer hits me. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, too many. Hey, cowboy, you buy some drink. Well, hey, baby doll, I will if you want, but I can't turn it off once I turn it on. There's no stopping me once I get going. Put a pin in my head, man, I'm wild as open. The tick-tock. Pizza next.
We are pizza.
That's going to be good, isn't it?
Yes.
Quite looking for that pizza. Saturday's pizza night because we don't have time to do anything else, do we?
No.
That's it. No. Still doesn't turn up till about 9:30. But by the time we've cleared everything up, turned everything off.
Yes.
It's a hard life. It is being a musician at the moment. It's just basically you sit at home all the time and eat pizza. It's hell, I can tell you. Well, ladies and gents, it's time to go, really. We've got time for one more. And then it's goodbye from me and Izzy over here. And Jasmine, of course. Mm-hmm. And Loki the cat that was responsible for a starting quarter of an hour late.
We'll post her picture up.
Yeah, we'll put a Loki picture up a bit later on. We'll, yeah. She's not going to get her in, so we'll just we'll try and get her in some kind of.
She was facing off with a squirrel about half an hour ago.
Oh really?
Yes.
Yeah, we've got a squirrel. Well, it's not where's our squirrel, I suppose, because it doesn't really live with us, but it stays in our garden a lot of the time. And the cat is very interested in the squirrel. As you can imagine.
The squirrel, not so much.
No, the squirrel's cat. Not happy. But it's quite funny though, because I'm pretty sure in a race between a squirrel and a cat, squirrel win. Don't you think?
I don't know. Should we find out?
We probably will at some point. We probably will at some point. Let's get the right noise for this. There we are. So, thanks everybody. If you have tipped, then thank you so much, because it really makes a difference. Look at this waif here. Look, that's here she is struggling to get through university.
Yes.
She's living on Red Cross parcels, right, and
I know. She's been to university and she's never been.
You paid for the university course that she hasn't done.
No.
Yes. Well, she has done it, but not at uni.
At uni, yeah.
But done it on a laptop. Yep. It's not really white, is it?
Nope.
So if anybody wants to, you know, blow $15,000 on looking at their laptop for a year, ask Jasmine. Yes. That's the advice that she will give you. Anyway, thank you everyone, and we'll see you on Thursday at 2 o'clock for the Cactus Club, when it's a bit of a mixture of everything, of course, and then we're back again next Saturday with this Foot Stomp, and we'll try and keep it currently the sort of stuff that you're probably learning back at the clubs now. Anna says a squirrel would win.
Yes. I reckon a squirrel could do us some damage.
Do you reckon?
Yes. Yeah, because you've got
who
to
would win
Loki is a bit of a wuss.
With a fight between a boy and a badger.
What?
I just want to know. We can figure out. We're talking
badger.
About... A badger would win, you think?
Yes.
Anyway.
Anyway.
We will see you next week at 2 and 6 on the Saturday. Of course, 2 o'clock on Thursday. And we'll leave you with this. High class lady, my new life. See you soon. We don't have much. on Thursday at 2 and next Saturday at 6 o'clock. See you then. Bye from all of us.